Hi, I'm Joachim for Statistics Globe, and in this video I'll explain how to convert a list to a vector using the R programming language. In the video I'm going to show you two examples, and both of these examples are based on the list that we can create with lines 2 to 6 of the code. So if you run these lines of code, you can see at the top right of RStudio that a new list object appears, which is called myList, and we can print this list to the RStudio console by running line 7 of the code. So after running this line of code, you can see at the bottom that our list contains 5 list elements, L1, L2, L3, L4, and L5. And each of these list elements contains one numeric value. Now let's assume that we want to convert these list elements into a vector. Then we can apply the unlist function, as you can see in line 9 of the code. And in this line of code, I'm applying the unlist function to our list object, myList. And then I'm storing the output of the unlist function in a new data object, which I call myVector1. So if you run line 9 of the code, you can see at the top right of RStudio that a new vector object appears, which is called myVector1. And we can print this vector to the RStudio console by running line 10 of the code. And then you can see at the bottom that we have created a new vector object which contains the 5 values that have been stored in our list object and which also contains the names of the list elements of our list. So let's assume that we want to remove these names from our vector object so that we only see the numeric values contained in our list in the vector. Then again, we can use the unlist function, as you can see in line 12. However, this time I'm specifying the useNames argument to be equal to false. And then I'm storing the output of the unlist function in another vector object, which is called myVector2. So if you run line 12 of the code, you can see that another vector object is appearing at the top right, which is called myVector2. And we can print this vector object to the RStudio console by running line 13 of the code. And then you can see that we have created another vector object which contains the same values as our previous vector. However, this time the vector objects are not named anymore. So in this video, I have explained how to convert a list to a vector object using the R programming language. However, in case you want to learn more on this topic, you could check out my homepage, statisticsglobe.com, because on the homepage I have recently published a tutorial in which I'm explaining the content of this video in some more detail, and I will put a link to this tutorial into the description of the video. Furthermore, if you have liked the video, I would be very happy if you leave me some positive feedback in the comments, and make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get notifications in future when I'm releasing new videos to the channel. That's it for this video. Thanks a lot. See you next time.